Uncovering history in Iredell County, library leaders in Statesville are trying to find out just how many people are buried in the city's historically black Green Street Cemetery, which dates back to the 1880s. Thanks for joining us tonight at 10. I'm Brian Blakely.
And I'm Alicia Barnes of Queen City News. Northeast Bureau Chief Sydney Heiberger spent the day walking the grounds, learning about its history from the expert tasked with finding what could be thousands of lost graves.
Each pink flag sticking out of the ground at Statesville's Green Street Cemetery represents a person Len Strozier has found buried there.
Just like the holy ground where my mom and dad are buried in Macon, Georgia. Those two GPS points are two of the most precious GPS points in the world to me. And I know that same feeling is for every single one of these flags.
Only about 300 headstones are visible, yet Strozier and local historians estimate 1,800 to 2,000 people are buried here.
When it starts in 1885, this is only 20 years after the end of the Civil War. The African American population here, a lot of them were ex-slaves. They didn't have a lot of money.
Eventually, community leaders hope to build a monument to honor all the unmarked graves and try to match some of the deceased with county death records.
It's right here.
For the locals, it's been an eye-opening undertaking, many with personal connections to those buried here.
This is a relative of mine deceased here. We were aware that we have family members in this cemetery, but to find this one, and it's a marked grave as well, is quite exciting, to be honest with you.
Through his search, Strozier has found unmarked caskets, bodies likely wrapped in quilts, and even grave markers that have been swallowed underground by years of overgrowth. Each step honoring those that rest here while listening to the stories of the living.
It's the heritage that reaches out to me and helps me understand. And then these people walk through the cemetery, they see what I'm doing, they understand what I'm doing, and they want to tell me their story, and all of a sudden the place takes life.
Reporting in Statesville, Sydney Heiberger, Queen City News.